All right, guys, so here we are. We're about to make the what kind is this? Honey caramel soap. All right. So, are we working with here? The oil at 130. My lye water is at 105. I don't want to wait anymore, so I'm just gonna risk it. I usually try to make sure it's within 15 degrees, but I think we're gonna be okay. Now, if not, that would mean that I've ruined this. You know, hopefully that's not gonna happen. Let's see here. I think we're fine. I think we're okay. We're good. We're just gonna go to emulsion with this. I don't know. Shea butter. Like, I started using shea butter instead of lard. This stuff is tricky to work with. You know, I can't super fat like I want to. I can't really. Gotta be careful. Think that's good. I think that looks good. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and add the fragrance right now. And stick blend that a little bit. Just a little bit. We don't want to go too far with it. Working with some colors that came from Amazon. Well, one color that came from Amazon. I don't know the vendor. I don't want to lie. It came in a pack of like 54 micas for like $30, so you know how this could go. This color is maple. Of course, the white is titanium dioxide. And I only want a little bit of the maple color. I only want a little bit of the maple color. That should be enough. That should be enough. I don't want to overpower it. Let's see. Because I've got in my head what I want to do. We can do a little bit more. All right, that's it. That's it. I'm going to stop right there. All right. I had made this titanium dioxide up, right? Do I want to use it? I don't think I want to use it. I think I want to leave my soap its natural color. I don't think I want to use the titanium dioxide. But I do want to use this. This is my maple colorant. I want to get like a nice caramel color. Let's mix that up a little bit more. I want to get a nice caramel color though. That's the idea. caramel honey type color. So we're gonna see. We're gonna see what this color does. Now, if it doesn't work out, as you can see, foolishly, I poured it all in this batch. Okay, I think that looks good. That's a nice deep. Okay, I like that. Alright. That's a nice deep caramel color. Alright. That's beautiful. What we say is beautiful now, we don't really know until after the cure. I'm soaping at such a high temp. It's probably gonna go through gel phase on its own. Now I need to figure out if I wanna do a drop swirl, or do I wanna do a in the pot swirl? I just want to try like one of my little tricks. I think I'm going to try one of my little tricks. Let's see. Where's my mold? One second. I'm having some technical difficulties with my mold. All right. Got it. All right. So, this mold, I had to. I don't know what to say, guys. Let's see. I'm trying to make the whole bar look like a honeycomb, okay? That's the idea. I want the whole bar to look like a honeycomb, right? So what I did with this mold is I took the mold usually has a silicone part. So I took that off. And I'm just using, I took the silicone out. And I'm just using I took the silicone out and I lined it with the freezer paper. Just the wooden part. So it can still be wide. You know, if you're putting the bubble wrap inside, it might not be as wide. Well, the bar wouldn't be as wide because it'll have that silicone mold, then the bubble wrap, and you know, I'd be cheating y'all out of some soap. So let's see. And I really wanted to get this done like the right way. I don't know what the right way is. Let's see. Okay. And see, I don't know if soap is going to go under this bubble wrap. And if it does that, that won't be good. Like, that'll defeat the purpose of this whole thing, right? I think that would definitely defeat the purpose. We're gonna pray that doesn't happen. Alright. Let's just pour. That's what we're gonna do. I'm just gonna pour it. Just gonna pour it. And I'll pour it slowly. I wanna make sure. Good. We're good. don't think anything seeped under the bubble wrap. If it did, I'll have to adjust next time and just not be lazy and wrap it in pieces too. But I didn't want to wrap, like the end pieces right here, because I'm going to be cutting them anyway. And it would be pointless for, two ends to have the honeycomb look. And then all the soap in the middle just have the edges with the honeycomb. You'll see what I'm talking about when I cut it. Never mind. Because I'm rambling. Y'all really should, give me things to talk about when I'm making this soap. Because as you can see, I will ramble on and on about anything. Alright. Now the swirl that I want to attempt to do will be one I just... All I actually do is pour. And I pour it right... down the middle. Right down the middle and on top. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, guys, that wasn't supposed to happen like that. But as you can see, I kept my cool. I kept my cool. I wanted to curse, but I can't curse, because at some point my kids are gonna see this YouTube video. I don't want them to hear daddy cursing like that. All right, y'all. Here we are to cut the honeycomb. The honeycomb soap I made. Well, it's supposed to look like a honeycomb. It's honey caramel scented. But it's been a while. I think it's been what, 2 days, I think. Tops look really good. Top looks real good. I was trying to wait until my new cutter came. My new soap cutter came. Like, you know, the one I have, I just rigged myself. But, it came Saturday, right when the runoff is closed. So I missed it. Of course, they're not open on Sunday, so I can't get it today. Tomorrow is a holiday, so I probably can't get it tomorrow either if they're not open. I wonder if the runoff is open on President's Day. I don't know. It doesn't matter now because I need to go ahead and cut this before it gets too hard. So, kind of missed out on that. I mean, hopefully it looks good though. I guess we're gonna see. It smells good. I can say that much. It definitely smells good. Hopefully it turned out right. See how we're looking. Okay, maybe good. Let's hope. Okay, yeah, we're good. We're good. We're good. Look at that. Good. And the bottom. Might actually make this the top. I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. Don't wanna it up too much though. All right, the moment of truth. Well, the second moment of truth is seeing what the inside looks like. Should be fine though. I'm not really worried about the inside. I'm lying. Yes, I am. Because I want it to be perfect. Let's see. How do we want to do this? Let's see. It might be good. Yeah, we'll be all right. Okay. Let's see here. I don't know. I'm gonna have to see. I did want it to look like a big honey drop though, so we might be good. Let's flip this over. Okay, I mean, I like it. It's a big honey dollop. I mean, it's not what I expected, I'm not gonna lie. But we're gonna put the finishing touches on this thing. We're gonna make it okay. We are going to make it okay. Like I said, it does smell really good. It really does. Let's see, I think I still want to do something a little different with it. We'll have to see. I'm gonna have to see. Now that's a really nice one. I wonder why all of them couldn't be like this one. I'm gonna have to show that one off. I'm definitely gonna have to show that one off. Okay, there we go. Pretty good, right? Well, I really like how these turned out. Like, I can't lie to you. I'm liking how they turned out. Especially the ones in the back. They turned out pretty good. End piece, a little sample bar for whoever. Probably me. Alright, guys. That's the cut. We'll be back if I decide I want to do something extra. But just in case, y'all have a good one. Hope you enjoyed the video. I've probably already said that once in this video, but I really do hope y'all enjoy it. Alright, y'all, have a good one.